Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You're seated at the right hand of the Father and intercede for all of us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is a source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved, and in those who know you, you regroup to merit. But though you are master of light, you judge with clemency, and with much more lenience, you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you, and you taught your people by these deeds, that those who are just must be kind, and you gave your children good ground for hope, that you would permit repentance for their sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is in the intention of the Spirit. because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord. So cute when they first pop their heads through the ground. some of the people that we associate ourselves with, and they get and they plant the wrong ideas in our heads. That's where those weeds come from. And we need to be aware that we have those weeds, and we need to prune those weeds out of our heart. And we need to make sure that we are putting the right things in our heart and keep those weeds away. Now, I would say, normally I would say, to get somebody rid of those weeds, we come to confession. I know that's not possible for a lot of us right now. But you can do somewhat of a confession at home. Go home, find your inner place, find your inner peace, and pray. And ask God to forgive you of the things that you have done and you shouldn't do. And then when the opportunity comes for confession, come up to confession and confess those and get those weeds out of your heart. We have to actively, just like we had to actively go every day or every other day to the garden and pull weeds if we're coming up, we have to actively pull those weeds out of us every day. Otherwise, they will get into us. And if you let the weeds grow in the garden, what happens? They choke out all the good stuff, right? It's not what we don't want those weeds to get in your heart and choke out the good that's in you. We want you to get rid of those weeds, pull them out, and be a good, good Christian. It's not easy to do. I've got a lot of weeds to pull. Right here. I know I do. And I think we all do. And it's an ongoing process. It's something that we need to think about and be aware of every single day. So I challenge you today, if you go home, is to find that inner place at your home where you can, and think about the weeds that you have in your heart, and ask God to help you pull those weeds and to keep the good stuff inside of you.
Gracious Father, Father, you have gathered us here at this table today. Unite us in mind, body, heart, and spirit in the one bread and that one sacrifice you give to us, so that we might someday, when our journey has ended here, be united with you, our one God, our one Lord, and our one Christ, forever. Friends, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you lay the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed mankind in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and to forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim together, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit on the mighty beautiful, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us. Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray and partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin, Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, let us be bold now and proclaim together that prayer that Christ gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and
glory are yours, now and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us turn to each other and offer a sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. preparedness and your prayerfulness and your patience as we experience liturgy in a different way. Some of you who didn't come last week or maybe haven't seen us on Facebook Live, we're going, well, what about the communion part? Well, that comes now. We're going to distribute communion row by row at the doors, the airlocks, as you go toward the parking lot. So when Deacon Mike and I have left, the ushers will guide you out row by row to receive the Blessed Sacrament at the doors. Cup your hands deeply to receive the Blessed Sacrament, and once you're outside, you can lower your mask and receive that Blessed Sacrament safely, far away from other people and their mouths and all those wonderful things. But also, we are all at this moment for people who are anxious, who are autoimmune, compromised, who can't come back into the building yet. We're also having our deacons go to the curb here on Hudson Lane, our entrance, and they are asked if they wish to come through and to receive communion in their car, since they've watched it on Facebook Live with us. And we're trying to do the best we can to involve as many people as we can, no matter where they are. So again, the three P's, and today sometimes we need all of them at once. Prayerfulness, preparedness, and patience. Thank you for all of those that you keep giving to this church and this parish. Also, as you go out, the traditional St. Vincent de Paul boxes have been repurposed